the four lads from Liverpool are off again with the assistance of the justly famous Bobby. And against the background of thousands of screaming fans, the daily ritual of going to work is like taking your life in your hands. Today's assignment is making their first movie, A Hard Day's Night, for United Artists. Behind barriers set up by police the night before, the fans urge their heroes on with the ear-splitting howl that has become a Beatles trademark. The location, Paddington Station in London, where the real business of movie-making begins. The crew and director Richard Lister busily set up shop. At different spots around the station, production assistants select eager extras for the thrill of their lifetime. They're going to be in A Hard Day's Night and doing what comes most naturally, chasing John, George, Paul, and Ringo, this time for the cameras. Imagine getting paid for all that fun. As though a Beatles wig wasn't enough, Paul adds something new to his makeup. The production schedule is made to be followed, and even the Beatles have to stick to a timetable. They pack themselves off to the afternoon location where the second crew is getting ready for them. There probably isn't anyone in the world who hasn't heard of La Scala Opera House. Here is that famous theater, only this one is not in Milan. It's in London, and playing host to another mob, a movie company, and the inevitable Beatles. Somehow, the four whimsical wonders have been sneaked past the waiting crowds and enjoy a few moments of relative peace. To prove that wonders never cease, producer Walter Shenson corralled 1,500 youngsters to fill the seats and make believe they're enjoying themselves. An accomplishment soon to get almost out of hand when the big scene starts on stage. Enter the Beatles, the universal cue for mass mayhem. They're going to treat the audience to some of the 11 songs that will be heard in A Hard Day's Night. Several bows later, the Beatles leave A Hard Day's Work to do their own version of A Hard Day's Night.